Victims of terrorism have been trying to hold banks accountable for laundering terrorist money, but the U.S. government, DOJ, DOD, well, they don't want that to happen. Attorney Chris Paulos joins me now to talk about what's happening here. Chris, this, to me, is an extraordinary story. I mean, we know that the banks washed money for terrorists. They admitted it. HSBC said, yeah, we did it. They signed a huge document where they admitted every bit of it. And now your case is to say they knew they were washing money for terrorists. We knew contractors were being killed, soldiers were being killed, and the banks should not get away with that. You would think the Department of Justice and the Department of Defense maybe would help you with that. Just the opposite is true this administration, isn't it?
That's right. Just recently, the Supreme Court of the United States asked the United States government, the Solicitor General, to basically give its perspective on a case that's it's considering taking up on an appeal and reviewing. And the government has now filed a brief saying that this case is not appropriate for the Supreme Court to review and that lower courts have interpreted a new law called JASTA appropriately. When in fact that's not at all the case. Courts have been applying an older standard, and this new law was passed in 2016 over Obama's veto. So frankly, to see the Biden administration come in and kind of take a swipe at this law that was, you know, a big loss for the administration that he was a part of at the time, I guess should come as no surprise. But the fact is that these cases against these banks are, as you point out, incredibly strong. We've got banks that have admitted to this conduct, and now we have plaintiffs who have been injured by it trying to seek redress in the courts.
Well, we're talking about thousands of soldiers.
Absolutely.
We're talking about thousands of contractors. I remember when Obama and Biden, when JASTA came out, it was to say, look, we can't let the banks get away with this. Okay, they can't just give money to criminals knowing that the criminals are going to kill U.S. soldiers and U.S. contractors and just say, that's okay. So law was passed, JASTA. You were very involved in that whole process. And then the Obama administration, Biden was vice president, tried to veto that. And the veto was overridden. But now this is another shot that this administration, through Biden, is taking at soldiers. That's what this is. This is just a complete shot at soldiers saying you may not recover knowing that we know where the money came from, we know it was washed, but you can't recover from that. That's exactly what this comes down to, isn't it?
Absolutely, and one of the things that makes this such a stinging position for the administration to take is that the DOJ itself has tried to prosecute or deferred prosecution of these banks and levied fines on them, which essentially are a slap on the wrist. The fines were abysmally low considering the conduct and the effect that it had, and basically didn't stop the banks from
well, they're still doing it.
Absolutely.
They're still doing it. And so in order, the fine you're talking about was nothing. It was during Eric Holder and Loretta Lynch had a chance to really punish these people for criminal activity. They agreed that they were criminals. Let's be very clear. They agreed, yes, we're criminals. Yes, we've done criminal conduct that cost the lives of American soldiers and U.S. contractors. And the administration, when that started, was Obama, and they said, well, we're not going to throw you in jail. We're not even going to do a criminal investigation. We're going to let you pay a $1.6 billion fine. And they made tens of billions of dollars, and the $1.6 billion was the cost of doing business. Did I get that right?
Pretty much. I mean, that's essentially what happened. And none of that money is reserved for victims or for any of the folks who have brought these lawsuits alleging that the bank's conduct facilitated the attacks against them.
What drives Biden to favor the banks over American soldiers?
Well, I think it's clear that, you know, banks have as much money as anybody in the world and that the money in politics is really driving a lot of these decisions or these positions. Things like Citizens United, where money is essentially the biggest mouthpiece that corporations have been handed to affect policy changes, and it's rearing its ugly head in decisions like this by the administration.
Okay, so there's no guesswork here. You can say money got to the bank through this terrorist organization on day one. You then have people that followed the money all the way down to the IED that blew up someplace on the globe? I mean, is that correct?
In some cases, that's absolutely the fact, but you don't even need to demonstrate that. Essentially, what the terrorist organizations and the front companies that these terrorist organizations have created, who are customers of these banks, were known to these banks at the time to be affiliated with foreign terrorist organizations. Any support to an organization that has...
Give me some examples.
So we're talking about Hamas. We're talking about the IRGC. We're talking about Hezbollah and Al-Qaeda. Those are foreign terrorist organizations where any support, no matter how small or what form it takes, is illegal, is improper. And these banks were providing non-routine banking services by washing money and allowing these organizations access to funds they would not have had otherwise. Mm. And then they can use those funds to fund its operations, pay its fighters, purchase weapons, and have greater influence and affect its own their operating capacity. The money, as we've heard Colin Powell say, is the lifeblood of terrorism. And these banks are the ATMs for these terrorist organizations.
So they make the decision, give us your political campaign money, banks, and we're going to forgive the fact that you have killed tens of thousands of U.S. soldiers really from all over the globe, not just U.S. You've killed tens of thousands of soldiers. They want their day in court to at least go after the folks that paid for that terrorism. They should have that right. But the Biden administration says no. They actually file with the Supreme Court saying it's really a bad idea to let these soldiers recover. That's basically what they're saying.
Yeah, and essentially they're saying that these lower courts, who we know have misapplied this law, have gotten it right, which is not at all correct. The errors that these courts have made in interpreting the law are obvious, and some courts have gotten it right.
Well, you know, it's interesting. While you're here, you're also handling a case right here in Pensacola, where we know that the Saudi government was involved in the terrorists that killed soldiers right here at the Pensacola NAS. We're not even getting help from the DOD on that, are we?
No, the Biden administration actually was an impediment to our efforts there. I've been on your show before. We've talked about how they've slow-rolled the service of process issues there, and they've been essentially coddling the Saudi regime and not been assisting us at all in getting documents or helping us prosecute that case.
Why has this case not been reported in regular media? I mean, corporate media. The only place you see this is in specialized media. Corporate media is not picking it up because they advertise for banks. Isn't that kind of the problem here?
I think that's what we're seeing as well. Is this just the influence that these institutions have because of how much money they have and the advertising dollars and the campaign dollars that they're willing to spend?
Same thing we saw with Saudi. We see it with Saudi Arabia all the time, don't we?
Absolutely.
I mean, you know, Saudi Arabia, they're supposed to be our buddy, even though they engineered and pulled off 9/11 and killed 3,000 Americans. They're still our pal. Why? Not because it's right, but because of money. And we haven't had a president that has shown any courage, where it comes to Saudi Arabia. And now we have a president, we've had two presidents in a row, that have shown no courage where it comes to these terrorist organizations that believe it's a good idea to wash money in American banks, European banks, and then convert that into IEDs. Basically, that's how that works,
yep.
Isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
Chris, thank you for joining me.
Thank you.
That's all for this week, but you can follow all these segments available right here on the coming week, right here on this channel, and you can follow us on Twitter at America's Lawyer. I'm Mike Papantonio, and this has been America's Lawyer, where every week we tell you stories that corporate media won't tell you because their advertisers won't let them or their political affiliations don't allow for it. We'll see you next time.